Hi there, this is Rutger Bus from Rutger Bus Photographic Moments from the Netherlands. And I was asked by Mike Shapiro if I could make a video in English about how to process your dark nebulosity in a program like Photoshop. So this is a quick tutorial to show you how I do it. So first of all, I will open my image in Photoshop. Here you go. Another thing to mention is if you want to do proper post-processing of dark nebulosity, make sure you have a lot of data. The more data you gather, the better it is and the easier it is to process it in a program like Photoshop. So I make this stack in the AstroPixel processor. It's about 6 hours of data of the Iris Nebula. You can already see Iris Nebula is coming through. And you also see a few dark lanes of dust. Now using Photoshop and layers and mask layers, luminosity layers, I will show you how I bring out the dust and not overcompensate the image for all other data in there. So first of all, what you do is you make a stretch of the initial image. So we'll go to image, adjustments, and levels. Here I make an initial stretch, bringing up the black point a bit, midtones, and you already see the dust is coming out quite nice. Can do it once again. Image, adjustments, levels, setting the black point a bit blacker, midtones a bit brighter. So here it is already, a nice stretched image of the Iris Nebula with this, all this dust in there. Once again, you need a lot of data to bring out these details, otherwise you will bring out the details, but not as good as when you have loads of data. So what I do, I will just duplicate the background. Drag it over here, duplicate the background, select, color range, and what I normally do is I try to find a spot where there is no nebulosity, so only dark background. So for instance, this spot here almost contains only the background. So I select this color, and what you will get is that you will make a mask of the pixels that has almost identical the same color, or at least you can select, you can brighten or darken the area, so make a brighter, a larger selection or a smaller selection. In this case, I like it this way. So I select OK, then you will get this nice marching ant overlay. Go again to select, and then choose select and mask. Click on it. And then you can fine tune the mask a bit, making it a bit less sharp. So I'd like it this way, and then I select OK. So with this mask selected, I add another adjustment layer, and then I choose levels. And what you do now is you just bring down, with the levels, you can bring down the dark areas to bring out the dust even better. Select like this, okay. But what you can also do, I will just delete this adjustment that I just did, Control Command Z. So basically, again, This is a non-destructive editing, so it's really nice. You can always go back to wherever you like to go. Make a new adjustment layer. Curves is also a very powerful tool to do it like this, making it darker like this. It's really nice. Just another one. I'm sorry. Go back a bit. Just merge these two layers. And with this layer, the top layer selected, select again color range, the dark areas again. Select the mask. Fine-tune your mask. This time I want it a bit brighter, a bit bigger, like this. Add a new adjustment layer. Curves. Not like this. Et voila, you brought out your dark, dusty lanes. Of course, you can do it better, but this was just a quick video to show you how it's done, or how I do it. I'm not sure if it's the right way and if I do it correctly, because I'm not a Photoshop wizard. But at least for me it works, and sometimes it needs a bit more adjustment. Sometimes you don't select the dark areas, but just select the brighter areas, in this case the dust lanes. And it will also work for deep sky objects like Pelican Nebula or Elephant's Trunk or whatever you like to enhance with Photoshop. So thank you for watching, and hopefully this video will help you in your processing of dark, dusty areas. Thank you. Bye.